on Fagan now sealing the ring to dropkick Murphys.
Are we back?
Yeah, I was saying Sean Fagan now sealing the ring to dropkick Murphys.
That he is.
There's a lot of worth noting, a lot of emotions going on with the last couple decisions.
So we're just gonna
move on.
Yes.
The co-main event of the evening.
This is the co-main event of the evening. Five rounds of action scheduled.
Both fighters have tie shorts. We're feeling good right about now.
Division.
Outstanding.
This is brought to you by Coors Light, the official beer of Friday Night Fights Muay Thai. Judges ringside, Joel Becker, John Nikolovich, and Tom Sconzo. Your referee, Vinny Chappell. Introducing first,
Sean Fagan,
he's
punching
fighting
himself
out
in the
of
face,
the red
giving
corner.
Greg Rowe an
he
early
wears
lead.
The red with gold, silver, and black trim. He weighed in at a ready and even 154 pounds. His amateur record, 14 victories against 5 defeats. He represents 5 Points Academy. From New York City, Greg Rowe. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the silver and blue. He weighed in at a ready 153 and one half pounds. His amateur record, 12 victories against 3 defeats. He has 6 wins coming by way of knockout. Representing Evolution Muay Thai from right here in New York City, Sean Fagan.
Greg Rowe, one of the more advanced guys at 5 Points Gym, and Sean Fagan, one of the more advanced fighters at Evolution Gym.
Just because of knockdown, go to the neutral corner, you stay there until I try to come out. Any questions, red corner? Question, blue corner? Touch him up, step back, let's get started.
Sean Fagan, really, as we were saying before, he's an anyone, anytime, anyplace fighter. He fought last year, Friday Night Fights, in an absolute war and rumble on the river, had a black eye, came out the next Friday and fought again with a black eye because someone else dropped. 2 fights in a week, both wins.
Very tough fighter. Both guys, strong builds, similar builds as well. Greg Rowe coming off a couple very solid wins.
Absolutely.
Lands a right hand and a right leg there to start off proceedings.
Yeah, Sean Fagan, very heavy right hand, has more of a boxing background. Was previously a boxer before going into Muay Thai. Only recently has he really started to round his game out to being less than just a hands fighter.
Greg
and
Rowe,
occasional kicks.
Greg Rowe, meanwhile, very strong straight knees, very strong round kicks, more traditional style.
Sean Fagan, as we were saying earlier, he last year in the 155-pound tournament, he was supposed to fight at 47. Made weight at 47, and because one fighter did not make weight, he gladly stepped up facing a guy who was 8 pounds heavier than him on one day notice. Previously from Kingston, from Black and Blue MMA with Chris Mosseri, recently moved down to Astoria. He's been training with Evolution for nearly a year. Now he's full-time focusing on Muay Thai, also writes a blog, Muay Thai Guy. Been training in Thailand, kind of rounding his style out to not just be a puncher. Very close fight so far.
Sean Fagan fighting southpaw at the moment. Haven't seen him do that before.
No, this is definitely a first.
And coming out southpaw still.
Greg Rowe, very calm, very composed. Both these guys have been in several 5-rounders. Fagan previously, the early part of his amateur career, was really known for being more of a brawler, but he's matured as a fighter. This is a 5-round fight, so he's not pressing the same way. Avoided a sweep there. Very close and technical first round. Both guys kind of throwing at 85%.
When the whole place is crowded, I'm about it. When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Both guys looking relaxed in their corners after that round one. Greg Rowe landing the solid body kicks, a lot of good counter shots.
Both guys looking like they're ready to go five here. If you're just joining us, Sean Fagan, blue and white shorts, training out of Evolution here in New York. He's in the blue corner. Greg Rowe, red and gold shorts, training out of Five Points Gym under Steve Mills in the red corner. Close. Now they're really close first round, pretty relaxed. Now they're starting to press the pace. They were throwing in the first, but they weren't throwing with mean intentions, I would say. It was much more feeling out. Both fighters, a lot of respect for each other.
Two great right knees from Greg Rowe into the rib cage of Sean Fagan. And the left knee straight in there as well. Greg Rowe very good with the knees, in and out of the clinch.
Definitely. Fagan much stronger with the hands. But Rowe so far really not letting Fagan get that big right hook off, which is what he's really known for.
And again, not sure what Fagan's strategy is coming out southpaw. He's known for his right overhand.
Exactly right.
Maybe looking to work the right hook to counter. Great
nice.
Takedown by Greg Rowe. Maybe looking to work the right hook to counter Greg Rowe's right leg.
Fagan, earlier last year, actually broke his opponent's cheekbone with one of those right hooks. So he's definitely known for having the... Oh, couple of good shots there by Sean Fagan. Finally starting to land with those hooks.
Greg Rowe gives him a straight knee.
Grabs the plumb position, grabs the clinch, and yeah, fantastic right knee. Both guys kind of doing their signature thing, what they are known for.
Fagan took a deep breath out of his mouth after that clinch.
I had to take a deep breath after watching that knee to the midsection. Oh, another strong knee by Rowe. Oh, kind of landed to the head, which you're not supposed to do in the amateur, but it definitely wasn't intentional, wrapping
Fagan's
up the
head,
second round.
Yeah, Fagan's head was low. Fagan kind of saved by the bell there, the position he was in.
Definitely not intentional by Greg Rowe to land upstairs. Both still very relaxed. Neither too winded. Both fighters still looking very strong, looking very ready to go three more rounds.
Greg Rowe in the red corner here being advised to look for the high kick. Body kick, high kick, he's being told.
Alex Ma and Brandon Levi out of Evolution cornering Sean Fagan. Greg Rowe at 14-5, Sean Fagan 12-3. Both these guys could be looking to go professional in the near term. Now Fagan is back. Oh, for a second, Fagan was back in the orthodox stance, looking for that right hook.
Great balance by Greg Rowe.
Definitely. Fagan, seems like Fagan was looking to be pretty slow in the first two rounds and now is trying to treat this like a third round fight, like a three round fight.
Straight knee from the outside by Rowe. And into the clinch goes Fagan. I don't think that's where his fight is.
You can see some of the damage from one of Rowe's knees to the left rib cage of Sean Fagan.
Yeah, he's fighting southpaw. His body is open to the straight right knee of Rowe.
And Rowe is taking, oh, nice right hook there by Fagan, though.
Snap Rowe's head back.
But then he finds himself back in the clinch, which is where Rowe has been doing so much of his damage.
Well, Rowe put on a knee guard there, maybe just trying to rest for a second after that right hand. Sean Fagan seems to be thinking about going back orthodox.
Yeah.
But then ends up southpaw.
He's definitely toying with the idea. Oh, Fagan ropes keeping him from getting tripped there.
Rowe lets him off the hook. Doesn't throw a kick. as Fagan was off balance.
Fagan looking with that big wild right hook again.
Boy, and look at the left side of Sean Fagan's rib cage.
Yeah, those right knees. The story told of those right knees. He has a tattoo on the right side, but I think it would have been better on his left on his right side. It would be better on his left side to kind of camouflage the effects.
Yeah,
there.
You might not see it with the red tattoo.
Oh, nice body shot there by Fagan, but Rowe catches it and sends him down to the canvas.
Right at the
bell. Wrapping up the third. Very strong round there for Greg Rowe.
Yeah. Sean Fagan had that one right hand that snapped Rowe's head back, but Rowe seemed to recover well, landed the knees that did the damage in that round.
Go. We're getting to the championship rounds, fourth round. Greg Rowe, red and gold trunks out of the red corner from Five Points Academy here in New York. Sean Fagan, blue and white trunks out of Evolution here in New York. Fagan taking two head kicks, not liking much of that, already sensing that he's behind. Does not want Rowe to extend his lead. Now he's back in the orthodox position, swinging away with those right hooks as he's traditionally known for. Oh, low blow Fagan. There by Rowe.
Fagan had his leg up, going for a side knee.
Strong knees in. By Rowe, but that one was definitely not in a good place for Fagan to be taking him. Fagan doing the sumo squat.
This is why Muay Thai fighters are wont to wear steel cups.
More traditional to have those kind of clashes when you're lefty-righty, as Fagan has been lining up. Kind of opens up the midsection, opens up the body to those. Fagan taking two more shots.
Oh,
Fagan taking some real damage.
Fagan took a left hook that almost buckled him, but then he came right back with a right hand of his own.
But he took two shots, a break, and then took three more before he fired on his own. Rowe kind of running away with this fight right now, looking very strong. Fagan looking pretty winded.
Yeah, other than a handful of good punches, it's all been one-way traffic, the
it
way
really
of Greg Rowe.
Been. Really has been. Rowe, anytime Fagan's able to get going with those short punches that he's so good with, Rowe's been able to clinch up.
Although there were two good right hands right there by Sean Fagan.
Yeah, I mean, every time he does it, though, Rowe knows he needs to get a hold of Fagan's head, pull him in close, and start working that clinch. Slow Fagan down, not let him get that momentum going. Nice left hook there by Rowe, by Fagan, but again, Rowe wisely seizing the back of Fagan's hand, head, pulling him into the clinch, scoring with the knees, not allowing Fagan to get that distance. Nice toss there by Greg Rowe. Fagan looking visibly winded. Again, Rowe, as soon as Fagan started to close the distance, ties up, keeps him from really doing any more damage.
Fagan has found himself in this position before when he is in need of a strong right hand, eight count his opponent. The problem is if that's what you've been doing all fight or trying for all fight, your opponent has an eye for it.
Yeah.
Last fight, Greg Rowe had out, though. He was running away with that fight due to knees, and I think I was right in the middle of saying his opponent needed an overhand right, and his opponent landed one. Eight counted Rowe and made a fight out of it. Rowe still won the decision. But we'll see what Fagan can pull out.
It's odd that the game plan of Fagan coming out southpaw and holding it till the fourth.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the
it really didn't allow him to get that right hook going at all.
Strange indeed. I almost wonder if the idea was to get Rowe
right
conditioned
hooks
to seeing him southpaw, and then he could switch to land the right hand as a surprise. But he comes out southpaw again here in round five.
Yeah, he does. Very, very surprising. Greg Rowe clearly ahead. Again, landing those knees to the midsection. You can see the effects of them now even more pronounced on the left side of the rib cage of Sean Fagan.
He's going to be feeling that.
No question. Fagan rushing in so aggressively that he winds up back in the clinch, which is where he does not need to be. Back in the clinch again. When he's this far behind, he's not going to get it done in the clinch.
That's right.
He needs to land a couple of these big right hooks, and he finds himself again in the clinch. Rowe securing the position with the glove on the back of Fagan's head. A couple of nice shots there by Fagan. Surprised Rowe's being willing to trade like this.
Yeah, Rowe seems okay. Let's have a trade up.
And does okay with it. Fagan looking visibly winded, likely the effect of so many those heavy knees to the midsection kind of knocking the wind out of him. Rowe looking tired as well. These guys have gone very hard for all five rounds. Fagan just never really got started in this fight.
Yeah. Rowe backing off now, knows he has the fight on points.
Nice knee to the midsection there by Fagan. Nice couple of shots.
Big knees by Rowe.
Yeah, Rowe looking for the distance in the clinch so he can throw those knees. Fagan looking to keep it tighter as we're wrapping up the fifth and final round.
Rowe looking for the spine with those knees.
Fantastic knees there by Rowe, wrapping it up. Rowe looking very winded, but had a very strong performance.
Yeah, he looks better every time I see him come out.
He really does. That is definitely the best I saw Rowe look. I did not expect him to run over Sean Fagan like that. I mean, I would have this as a shutout for Rowe.
Yeah, so would I.
Except with the exception of the first round, which could have gone either way, where they were really just feeling each other out. But the fight really started in the second. And two through five, I saw all for Rowe.
Yeah, no doubt.
Fagan going for that big right arm.
The gang always plays 00 just once. And sometimes, absolutely nothing becomes absolutely everything. Among life's millions of moments, some of the very best are made by Mohegan Sun. When it's your time to shine, come see us.
Ladies and gentlemen, you already know. Let's make some noise out here for both of these fighters. After five rounds of action here at the Broad Street Ballroom, we go to the judges' score totals. John Nikolovich scored this bout 49-46 for Sean Fagan. Tom Sconzo scored this bout 48-47 for Greg Rowe. And Joel Becker scored this bout 48-47 for your winner by split decision, representing Evolution Muay Thai, Sean Fagan!
Main event coming up next.